will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take.
Welcome you to this divine assignment, activating destinies that are lulled, that are in abeyance, that are stuck. We are delivering your destiny and people that are bound, people that are distracted, people that are deceived, people that have gone astray. Beloved, it's a call, a clarion call to return to the foundation of our faith and the truth of the gospel. Matthew 28, once again, verse 18, and Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore. The command is to go, not to sit and wait for them to come. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son, Jesus Christ, and of the Holy Ghost. See? It says, go and make disciples of them. And you baptize them in the name of the Godhead, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Somebody said to me, well, how is it then that the apostles baptized people in the name of Jesus? I said, well, didn't you read that Jesus says, I'm in the Father and the Father in me, and we are one. If so, if you say Jesus, the Father is there. Say the Father, Jesus is there. You can't separate them. Jesus goes further and says, listen, if you don't believe in the Son, you don't have the Father either. If you have the Father, then you have the Son. You can't separate the wet from the water. They are one. For the purposes of redemption, I keep reminding people, Jesus came to become a man, but he came out of the Father. He says, no man has seen the Father's shape but me. Nobody knows what he looks like. I am the only one. I came out of the bosom of the Father. Why are you all deceived, Jehovah Witnesses? Why are you all deceived, all you false religions, making noise, splitting scriptures, instead of believing the truth as it is stated in the Word of God, the whole counsel of the Word of God? Listen to it. He said, go and teach them, not preach to them, teach them. And you baptize them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. Watch this. Teaching them to observe all things. So it's not going and say, you know, many times I've seen people come and say, oh, you know, 200,000 give their life to Christ. I say, well, how do you know? The people say the prayer doesn't mean they have come into the Lord. We are not commanded to go and get them to say a prayer. And then that's it. We are commanded to go and make them disciples. Any crusade that does not follow with, you know, weeks and months of trained teachers teaching those converts and bringing them into the kingdom is a waste of resources. We're in a spiritual warfare. Any military that will go and take a territory and then just vacate, simply waste their time, because as soon as you vacate, the enemy moves right back in. The apostles preached the gospel and established churches. That's what we are called to do. Well, the church is just a vehicle to disciple them. But even if you don't start a church, let the leaders, let the evangelists come in and work with leaders that would then follow up these people. We must get people saved and then put them in disciple classes. That's what we are told to do. If you get somebody saved on the job, then follow them up. Minister to them, even if they refuse initially to come to your church, then follow them up daily, ministering to them, sharing with them, teaching them to observe the things the Lord has commanded us. So you have to know the scriptures yourself. You have to model it. God is nudging my spirit to keep teaching, motivating. I'm doing it in the church, and I'm doing it on this devotional. I'm doing it everywhere I go. It's time for the true church, the remnant, to awaken, to confront the culture, to defend the gospel from false prophets. I can name them, they're all on the web and everywhere. People that once preached the gospel, even have a church. How can you come out from, how can you be a son of a Robert, what Carlton Pearson is doing, and preaching, you know, fallacy and error? spewing out poison. May God save his soul. And saying that he wasted 50 years of his life. I heard it myself. Beloved, don't listen to error. God is not too big to have 10 ways to him. He loves us and sent his only son to bring humanity back. Doesn't matter what religion you are of. Why would Jesus go to hell to preach to every spirit in prison? And you are alive and telling them they can get to God without the Lord Jesus. You false prophet, stop it. Their blood will be on your hands. It's time to stop. Hear the word of the Lord. Jesus says, teaching them to observe all things I've commanded you. Did Jesus teach you to come tell the people to follow other religions, to follow other faiths, to follow other names that will not save? Haven't you read in the scriptures? It says, there is no other name given among men whereby we might be saved but the name Jesus Christ. Haven't you heard the word of the Lord, beloved? Awake, thou that sleepest, arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. The gospel is not an arena to win friends and influence people. I know we cannot stand sound doctrine anymore. Jesus says, I didn't come to bring peace. I came to bring the sword, to divide people one from another, to separate the wheat from the chaff. Where did the gospel of accommodation come from? The gospel is a weapon of war to disciple men, to get men out from satanic clutches and false religions and deluding devils, blinding the minds of them that believe not, the Bible says. These are strong words, but that's what we need in our generation. That's what we need now for the church to wake up. We need true prophets to arise and rebuke and teach and correct. Be offended, but you will remember on the day of judgment that you heard the word of the Lord. Be offended, but awaken and change. And let God use you as a mighty weapon to bring others into the fold to preach the gospel. That's the word of the Lord. That's our charge. That's our command, beloved. And I'm you a small part of God's weaponry to awaken the dead church and to call the sinners to repentance. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.